Well, the UK is the world's second biggest research market. It's huge. It's very, very valuable to UK PLC. But of course, international is growing and growing. We export a lot of our expertise. So an international network like this gives much more opportunity for our members to access those global markets, which are quite hungry for the sort of experience and longevity that we have to offer. So it's great for UK exports and it's great for our members.
I think it's a great time. It's the right thing at the right time for research. I think that there's many associations around the world that have got a lot of knowledge built up. There's also a lot of nations and a lot of associations around the world with very small markets that are just looking to establish themselves. So it's a great time to be able to cross-pollinate that information to really help nations that are trying to establish themselves in the research industry.
Well, I think the network has a key important role because the national associations are one important player in the industry and for the business, research business. There is not really no one that knows better the country that the research is doing by, except for the national associations. So we have to create new associations where there are no associations. We have to nurture the associations that exist, and of course we have to reinvigorate the business. If we succeed to have these three goals, we will do a great service for the industry, not only globally, but also locally.
Here at the MRS conference was our first meeting of GRBN. The second meeting will be held April 18th and 19th at the Global Research Conference of CASRO in Miami, Florida. And at that meeting, we will be able to announce the agenda for the next 12 months.
Ephemera has been around for 20 years, and we find ourselves facing so many issues again and again and again. And when we look overseas, we see those issues being replicated, for example, in the United States, where they're going through a similar process just in regards to privacy laws and regulation. And what we see is that so many associations have the same experiences that we can learn from. And the network provides an opportunity to exchange that information directly, both formally and informally, and it allows us to provide, for the national associations in turn, to provide better value to their members, better information to their members who want to look at those other markets as well. So primarily it's a means of information and exchange.
I think one of the key issues in research is understanding profitability, how to make money out of research in 2012 and beyond. So I think that if ideas of how to create efficiencies within research, how to take advantage of new technologies within research, if that kind of information can be shared easily and best practice in speakers, that would be great.
Well, what we want to is to select a short list of activities that we can accomplish by facilitating this change between the federations and between the countries. So at the end of the day, what we want to accomplish is if something is happening that has a good practice in, let's say, Brazil, can be exported, can be translated to Finland, or from Mexico to Colombia, or from Colombia to Australia.
What we're looking to do is support the business of research. There's been, you know, for 60 years we've had codes of conduct, we've had discussions about methodology and those sort of things. And what, in terms of the way the business, the commercial research is run, businesses need support to understand how they access new markets, but also small and medium-sized enterprises rely heavily on their national associations to provide them with expertise in areas of procurement, training, legal advice, and the GRBN will add to the sum of knowledge and make that information more available to allow those small and medium-sized enterprises to succeed.
Well, we believe that the strength of research businesses and the integrity of the research industry as it changes in the next several years, and it's changing already, will be its continued self-regulation. And so our job, our objective, and really the importance of GRBN is to support the continued self-regulation of research businesses around the world as they change.
Well, I'm hoping that those that do want to make those international connections will have real and practical help doing it, because this is a grouping of research businesses, and so they must be about promoting the business of research. And a lot of our members have said to us, international is where it's at, how can you help us more? This is the first step.